讲一下哈，我们有位弟兄，他叫做 Joseph Calicamo， 也算是我们这一组里面外国人当中一个蛮有才华的一个牧师。然后他礼拜五的时候过世，那他才过世的时候才54岁 ，so he was only 54 when he passed on。但是呢，我们那个时候我们是有点纳闷，为什么他这个时候他会过去啊，怎么样子的？但是我现在跟各位讲的就是说哈，在他过去之后呢，不久就有两位，一位弟兄，一位姊妹，有看到他到天上的华美的样子，他看见他的这个在背后走到天堂的那个样子，他穿的五彩的衣服，然后呢，他大概是三十来岁的样子，跟我们现在这个样子不太一样。我们现在大概都是四五六十岁了，那他那个时候才30来岁，他的那个样子。然后呢，他样子真的是非常的好。除了他之外呢，还有另外弟兄也有看到他。那我是觉得感谢主，因为我其实我们在天堂法庭，这个叫做天堂法庭。以后有机会的话，我再跟各位这个解释什么是天堂法庭。我们到那个天堂法庭要做什么，以及在那边我们在那里看到的什么东西，真是非常非常感谢主。所以他们在那里对在天上的人没有难过，他说：“哎呀，真是好高兴，在那里看得太好了。”只是在地上的人在难过，叫他的这位朋友。他的朋友就说：“哎呀，这个他都没有认识跟他这样子年纪的人了，因为他79岁了，那没有像他这样子的人。但是他在天上有很多朋友，可是他在地上什么时候事情要做完，他能够走，他不知道。但是他那个脸是喜乐的，所以我是上礼拜六去看这位弟兄，也是我们在以赛亚19里面一起服侍的弟兄。”那这个好，现在讲到我们的这个这个荧幕里面那多半人是知道是Isaiah 19，但是也是因为 Porter Shield 来的。那我是呢Isaiah19ministries.org， 我们叫做 Isaiah19ministries.org， ORG， 在里面你可以上去看我们的内容。OK， 那我们也是Porter Shield， 我们也是总统盾牌里面的人。那 Porter Shield 是4、5年前的时候就开始有了，2016年、2017年的时候开始。那这个多半是总统选举的时候才会跳出来的。那这一次川普总统，我是想，哎呀，他来的话，正好我们可以出来，就是说用这个荧幕来讲他的话。讲川普总统啊，然后我们要做什么的话，可是没想到这个川普总统这个事情越搞越久，但是很快大家又应该今天我想会听到一些消息。 OK， 我们感谢主。那总而言之呢，我们在以赛亚19那就是 Isaiah19ministries.org 跟我们 Porter Shield 这两边就分开来，所以说我在我们的讲话的我们的那个 LINE 的那个 group 里面，是希望大家在以赛亚19的里面就不要讲这总统盾牌的事情，因为就讲以赛亚19的事 ，OK。然后呢，总统盾牌的事情，我们就讲总统盾牌这个现在国内到底发生了什么事情。但是在美国发生的事情，其实大家都很注重的，像我们在美国发生的事情，台湾的也在乎，大陆的也在乎。这个澳洲的人也在乎，搞不好加拿大的人也在乎，我们这些人都非常在乎那到底发生了什么事情。所以我们总统盾牌要来讲这件事情。那以赛亚19我们讲别的事。那以赛亚19的事情精不精彩？我告诉你，非常的精彩，非常非常的精彩。我们从埃及讲到亚述，我们讲到以色列，这些地方我都去过，在那遇到的人真的是怎么讲，跟这里是完全不一样的。到时候我们再说这个那件事情。好，我们现在来讲这件事，这是总统盾牌的，最近川普他 这个礼拜讲了几我不晓得他讲过几次话了啊，最起码有一两次了吧 ？OK 啊，那我听说这个Michael Yu 牧师听了四个钟头，最起码四个钟头，那你听的比我还要多，所以我们今天也要请这个Michael 那个牧师来告诉我们他听了什么东西，然后呢之后呢，大概45分的时候。Mark Gonzalez 牧师他就是也是很厉害的，他那个老兄是全美国管那个墨西哥裔，应该是说墨西哥后代的人在美国他是最大的一个人，那他跟那个我们这边的政治也非常的有接触，他其实Michael Yu 牧师对我们这边政治也蛮有接触的，但是我们的那个Mark Gonzalez 牧师真的是整天为我们应该是说基督徒站得住，在为我们基督徒来这边争取基督徒该有的这个权位，那我非常非常感谢他，我也很高兴他也成为我们以赛亚19的那个副主席。好，我们再来讲，请问我们先来祷告好了。OK， Millie 跟那个 Sherman， 你能够为我们祷告吗 ？Can you pray for us? And also Hannah, can you also pray for us? For the meeting. Thank you.
亲爱的主耶稣，我们感谢赞美你。每当我们聚集在一起的时候，是你为我们预备的。主，我们感谢你，因为我们有你，所以我们成为你的儿女。主要当我们来聚集的时候，我们真的是为我们这个国家，我们知道你喜悦，因为你不愿意一人成人，你愿意人人都得救。主要我们在为这次的会议，我们知道你自己在仍然在做工，我们不知道川普将来要做什么，但是我知道他仍然在你的手中。当我们来到你的面前，我们寻求主你自己的圣洁临到我们的时候，对吧？我们就知道你在当中。主啊，我们知道我们这个时候我们的心是向往你的，我们把今天从头到尾的 meeting 全然交到你的手中，愿你自己在其中的祝福，愿我们的话语达到你的天庭，愿你自己来成就一切该成就的事，圣洁的神垂听我们的祷告，奉耶稣基督的名求，阿们
阿们。是的，主耶稣，谢谢你，你这样爱我们，把我们摆在这个世代，而这个世代我们也知道是非常非常关键的时刻。欧主，你让我们经历今年的总统大选，你也让我们经历在这个大选的期间，我们看到的一切事情其实都带着深刻的意义，有时候不见得合乎我们心里所想望的，然而你的应许立定在天，你说神叫万事互相效力，叫一切爱神的人得益处。主，求你提升我们，让我们是每天怀着欢喜快乐的心来看你在做些什么，而不是说想要你做些什么。主，我们盼望你在这些事情当中能够早早的让我们看见你所要成就的一些事，特别我们看到在美国这边的整个的变化，乃是跟台湾、跟中国、跟中东、跟以色列的情势的情况息息相关的。我们也看到以赛亚19的 ministry 的整个的事工，也是跟这些的发展息息相关的，所以我们就要一步一步的跟随你，求你带领我们，也保守我们身体健康，为你的百姓，为所有爱你的人祝福祷告。纪念我们今天晚上在这里的聚会，这样子，奉主耶稣基督的名，阿门。
阿门。
们亲爱的耶稣，谢谢你，主啊，你联合列国，主啊，进到这个带到的这个群组里面，主啊，是有你的心意。主耶稣，你把台湾，主啊，把澳洲，主耶稣，中国大陆，主啊，各地，美国，主啊，美国北加、中加、南加，主啊，这些地方的的爱你的，主啊，关心美国的这个。这个事工的所有的基督徒，主啊，你都把我们聚在一起，主啊，因为你要我们一起来了解，一起来进入到你的心意，主啊，主啊，你的意念高过我们的意念，主啊，主啊，你的道路高过我们道路，主，我们要在这里一起来寻求你的主啊，主啊，你的旨意，主啊，一起来寻求主啊，你在我们心中每一个人个别生命的带领，主耶稣，谢谢你，主啊，当我们聚集在这里的时候，主啊，你就给我们那个能力，主啊，让我们也能够去应付我们自己各自生活上所要面对的挑战，主啊，各自每一个人生活上要面对的生命的学习。主耶稣，主啊，求你透过今天的这样子我们在这里的聚集，主啊，你提升我们每一个人在属灵上的认识。主耶稣，谢谢你把我们聚在这里，主啊，因为你爱我们，主啊，你就呼召我们，主啊，主啊，你就聚集我们在你的面前，主啊，好像小鸡聚集在那个在聚集在你的面前一样。主耶稣，谢谢你，主啊，为我们以下的聚会向你献上感谢祷告，奉耶稣得胜的名，阿们。
阿们，阿们，感谢主，欢迎这个各位到我们的这个开会这边来。那在我们的那个 Mark Gonzalez 出现之前呢，我们还有这个Pastor Michael Yu， OK， 大家已经认识 Pastor Michael Yu 了，他是怎么讲？他对我们的政治也蛮理解的。我们1月6号的时候还一起去那个 Washington DC， 然后呢在那里待了好几天，两三天了，然后回来。那我也是大概是最近的时候才认，我是最近的时候认的 Michael Yee， 那他是在那个之前就已经认识过我。我是希望说大家能够对他所说的也能够了解。我们谢谢，请你们把你那个 microphone 那个打开来，然后告诉我们，你觉得现在的这个美国的政治情况现在是怎么一回事了？还有这个川普总统这个礼拜有出来讲话，终于出来了，然后他讲的话，他说了些什么？然后他是希望做什么？那我们应该要做什么？你能不能告诉我们？谢谢。
好，我有一个好消息告诉你们，也有一个坏告诉你们。坏消息呢，就是我们今天主要的讲员 Mark 呢，他要到8:45 or 8:40才会出现，正是 bad news。希望他以后能够8点就出现。好消息就是我们的川普总统终于出现了，终于王者要归来了。好，那么。我讲一个故事哈，我不知道有没有讲过，如果过去讲过你们姑且再听一下。就是这个牧师啊，礼拜六晚上很不舒服，打电话给教会的长老说明天我恐怕没有办法站讲台讲到了，你帮我站代替一下。这个长老啊非常的高兴，说没问题牧师啊，因为他巴不得这个到讲台这个传讲神的信息，已经巴望了很久了，终于机会来了。所以呢他第一次站讲台传讲信息礼拜天早上他就读了约翰福音第6章，耶稣用五饼二鱼喂饱5000人。读完以后，因为他太紧张了，所以他说耶稣用5000个饼2000条鱼喂饱5个人。那一天晚上呢，牧师听了录音带哈，觉得哎呦糟糕了，这个把神的话讲错的不得了了哈。所以下个礼拜天呢，牧师用同样的经文要拨乱反正。那么念完经文以后呢，牧师呢用肢体语言强烈的来表达说，撒耶稣用5个饼2条鱼喂饱5000个人，你们相信吗？众人说相信相信相信。牧师说为什么？会众异口同声说因为上礼拜剩太多没吃完啊。耶稣用5饼2鱼喂饱5000人， 这个叫做神迹 miracle。耶稣可不可以用五千个饼、两千条鱼去喂五个人呢？很多人说不行，可以，这叫恩典。我们需要神迹啊！很多人说，可能三月四号，很快的这礼拜四会有大事发生，那需要神迹。但是我们更需要恩典，我们每一天都要靠上帝的恩典而活，不管环境怎么改变，不管环境是不是照着我们所期待的有神迹出现，我们每一天都需要上帝更新的恩典。我不知道你们今天有没有在 YouTube 油管有一个频道叫 American Events， 它有一个19分钟09秒的新闻，但是这个新闻不是用英文播的，这个新闻全部是用瑞士话播的。它上面一个 title 说 Donald Trump Surprise Visit。哎，我刚刚哪时候谁帮我 mute 啊？我是讲到哪里 mute？
最后一句
，surprise visit Switzerland。
哦，对 ，OK， today in YouTube have a channel called American Events， and they have a title called Donald Trump surprise visit to Switzerland。
对不起，
今天在油管
以外的人，请你们自己静音好吗？
好，我不晓得这个消息哈，是今天的真的还是过去的？
旧的，
哦，是旧的。可是它上面写3月1号。
Yeah, old film.
Very good. 啊 ，so clarify 哈。好，那么昨天我花了四个小时看在 Orlando 哈 CPAC 最后一天啊，从头一直到结束哈啊，四个小时，其中川普大概占了一半的时间。川普讲了很多内容，当然有讲到要弄一个新的一个 voting 选举的一套规矩，而且一天就完成啊，不能晚到的，然后要给 ID 啦，然后讲了很多过去历史上从来没有的一个在任的总统啊，他怎么样啊，所以他主要的重点第一个哈，他就讲这个。这一次选举是确选啊，被盗窃了啊，那么他赢了两次，最后说他可能会再赢三次啊，所以这个是带了很大的暗示。那么过去美国历任总统退休以后都退出江湖，隐蔽江湖，也不再管政事，也很少会去评头论足啊，批评这个在位者的任何的事情啊。川普是打破传统，他是第一个啊。他讲了弊端以后呢他开始批评这个拜登这个上位第一个月是一个灾难讲了好多事情，包括这个油管哈这个多少万人失业，然后不去限制俄罗斯的油管，把美国的跟加拿大油管也停止了哈，那么这个开放边界剩一点点就完成了，他的下令停止，然后这个真是一个灾难。为什么？因为现在已经有成千上万的人已经陆陆续续往这个美国边界赶了，他们就等待拜登一下令通进来。你可以想象这么多人我们的教堂我们的学校都被强迫关闭，没给他戴口罩，这些人来你去看影片，没有人戴口罩的，也不检查 COVID 的所以这个放这些人进来，这个简直是让人匪夷所思。一个真正有智慧有脑袋的头这个总统绝对不会干一个破坏自己国家的事情，所以他根本不是 American Force， 是 American Last， 所以我们今天已经从 Force 到 Last， 所以我们希望有神迹出现，不要等到2022年，就在这段期间很快的有神迹出现。当然我们有很多的我称它小道消息哈，因为都没有经过证实嘛哈，所以我们需要神迹，但是我们还是要靠上帝的恩典哈。第二，他的演讲里面哈谴责了一个一个点名，谴责了那一些投票赞成 弹劾他的这些 Rhino， 他还特别提到 Rhino 哈，这个 Republican in name only。 所以我在想这一些人到2022年可能全部都下去了。那么谴责完以后他又讲到他们想要做的事情，可是呢很可惜的就是川普在演讲里面没有讲到很细的他们到底怎么做，到底怎么样王者归来。不过我另外一方面想哈，可能也不能讲，因为把风声落出去了哈，这个敌人就知道你要干什么了啊，他们就到处防堵你。我相信他们已经有了一套的策略啊，而且已经 recruit 了啊这个志同道合的人。所以我们继续要用祷告啊，一方面来等候神迹出现，一方面祷告来摧毁这个魔鬼撒旦借着左派啊他们的计谋，他们所要这个树立的巴别塔啊 one world government 哈、啊、这个世界统一的。所以你看他们所做的全部是敌对上帝的，真的是你可以想象一个正常人的思维不会去干那一种事的。所以他们都是有病的人，有病的人要看医生，所以他们需要耶稣啊。但是呢我都不知道他们会不会悔改，因为法老王神给他十次的机会，所以他越加的刚硬。那么拜登啊不川普总统不是一个人可以成就这个事的，也不是他一个团队，他需要唤醒美国所有的保守派7500万或8000万甚至1亿投票给他的。上次Martyr 他讲到在2020年大选当中有 46% 的教会是投给拜登，匪夷所思啊，对不对？你投给拜登就是支持他们同意同性恋，同意堕胎啊。现在更过分的，以前国会开会都是要祷告的，现在他们 不准祷告，而且请穆斯林的国会议员来向他们阿拉祷告。所以我们可以看见这整个左派生成这种背后的强大势力就是魔鬼撒旦的集团。所以这是一个巨大的属灵征战，我们已经在最关键的时刻，所以这也是我们最美好的机会。很多人啊说生不逢时，哎呀碰到第一次世界大战第二次世界大战，但是我们何其有幸我们能够被神放在这个幕后的时代，我们可以投入参与国度的事业。那么这个征战绝对是激烈的，因为圣经说凡是要在主里面敬虔度日都要受逼迫，如果你没有受到逼迫表示撒旦觉得他还看不上你，如果你受了逼迫那我要感谢你啊！我可以知道我们做传道人、啊、开始受了逼迫，因为我在教会我是不讲政治的，但是我讲社会的议题竟然也会有人攻击啊！有一个教会我上次提过，长职会写信告诉我啊，就是叫我以后不要在教会里面讲政治。后来我审视我的讲章，我没有讲政治，我只是要大家关心。你看哈，魔鬼撒旦现在利用少数的人控制教会，控告牧师，然后压制牧师，可以说什么不可以说什么，这个已经在美国发生了，而且在华人教会就是少数的。我不相信所有弟兄姐妹，因为我私底下有打电话给那个教会的弟兄姐妹，某些人打对啊你讲得很好啊，但是在12月24号他们教会有一个退休的教授打电话骂我，骂了30分钟还气愤愤的，我可以想象他两个脸那个肉是颤抖的。他说川普是假冒为善的人，其实我告诉你他是真正假冒为善的人，因为我太认识这个教授，我突然才醒悟过来，原来美国的大学真的被 brainwash 太厉害了，连大学教授 啊，他是北京出生到台湾，在台湾长大，十岁到台湾，然后来美国做终身职教授，你知道，他可以用他一人的影响力，告诉长执会，写信给牧师，要我封嘴。我告诉你，上帝感动我讲的，我还是会讲，啊，所以我打算不会退缩的，我打算把教会几乎大部分人我都打过一次电话，问他们的意见以后。我要写一封信给这个长执会，因为我一定要回应他，所以我们可以看见，我可以理解到，这个川普过去四年真是不容易，因为他要立志遵守神的道，但是被邪恶的势力抹黑、捏造各样的坏话、毁谤、污蔑，黑的说白的，白的说黑的，所以我们。看见川普，我们应该知道他是我们的弟兄，是一起为神的国度受苦的。我们不但为他祷告，我觉得我们每一个人可以做的，就是在我们的教会，在我们的朋友圈，甚至在我们小孩当中，我们需要传讲真理，说出真相。你看现在的小孩啊，尤其在美国出生长大的 ABC。在美国受的大学教育几乎都是民主党的，真的，我们的小孩四个里面有两个是，两个不是啊？为什么？越小的越是啊。像我老大老二他们会讲中文啊，我们有送他去中文学校，所以我觉得这个有时语言文化会影响的。老三老四呢中文不是很好啊，所以再加上老三在芝加哥读书，芝加哥是左派大本营，老四 UCLA 读书， UCLA 也是被左派。那么可是你讲小孩子们他们会反抗，所以我有时候呢就吃饭的时候坐下来祷告，我在祷告里面潜移默化他们，让他们知道我们的立场是什么，我们的想法是什么，而且并且为他们祷告啊。所以我觉得我除了祷告以外，我们希望我们的火、啊、要堆在一起，火才会旺。我们不是一个孤军奋斗，那么我们需要投入参与、啊、就是说在整个、Great Awakening、啊、大觉醒的运动当中、啊、那么我相信我们是属于得胜者那一群的。他们看起来暂时好像用偷窃的，但是从来在历史上没有一个偷窃者他可以永远永远、啊、不被揭发的。现在他们已经到厚颜无耻的地步， Time 都可以把他们怎么作弊写得详详细细。川普在演讲里面有提到 Time 吗？他说我读了，我鼓励你们去读哈。你看他们现在不怕你知道，选前、拜登甚至讲我们弄了一套这个前所未有最严密最广大的一个投票的欺诈系统，他们不怕你知道。以前小偷啊都是在半夜、啊、你知道，现在小偷啊都是光天化日之下，特别都是在中午啊。所以人家说干坏事啊一定要在中午干，为什么？因为早晚会被知道的。所以他们现在、啊、都光明正大不怕你知道，为什么？高等法院是他们开的，法院是他们开的，所有都被他们用钱收买、啊、所以贪财是万恶之根。所有人被钱收买以后，他们心就变了，因为人的心啊，一个心不能侍奉两个主，所以当他心在钱财的时候，上帝的公义就不在他心里。所以我们也欢喜快乐，为什么？因为神定义要借着这一次的选举来唤醒教会，来唤醒很多的人，并且让他们知道这个世界需要有正义，需要有公理。就好像上礼拜我们 Ohio 有一个弟兄在网上叫 Kevin 廖，他讲说他在公司里面有很多黑人都是民主党的，但是他们觉得这是很多事情 something wrong 不对了，为什么？ 因为他们把总统禁言不准讲话，在 YouTube 在脸书在推特都不准讲话、哎、他也是一个美国公民，宪法第一修正案保障我们有言论自由，现在不要说他了，连我们啊，我们要发表一些他们觉得不是他们合他们意的，他就把你给 censor 了。所以我们要不断的发声、啊、我们毫无畏惧。所以上帝给我们的不是胆怯的心、啊、乃是刚强仁爱谨守的心。我们要刚强壮胆，但是呢，我们要仁爱，就是我们要充满了爱、啊、我们对各自国家要充满爱。你看川普、啊、在去年的 CPAC 演讲完以后，他抱着国旗，他不是作秀啊，他真的爱这个国家，爱这个百姓、啊、我觉得求主啊，挑起我们心中那个火，就好像提摩太后书第二章，这个保罗告诉提摩太说、啊这个要眺望，眺望，我们要被眺望起来，我们的信心被眺望起来，我们勇敢的心被眺望起来，爱主的心被眺望起来，我们还要刚强仁爱谨守啊，我们要谨慎啊，我们所做的事所说的每一句话啊，我们不是在血气里面，真的，如果在血气里面，我们一定打败仗的。我们不能用他们的方法，我们要用神的方法，神有他的时候。所以我再 summarize 一下，第一个，我们知道神借着川普啊带来一个大觉醒，那么我们也相信未来是美好的，因为他说我们四年前开始啊一个美好的旅程啊，但是旅程远远还没有结束。是的，美好的事正在发生啊，所以有首诗歌说，美好事一定要成就，美好事已显明啊，我们又在一起来赞美主。所以当我们信徒国度的精灵在一起，我们祷告，我们一起赞美的时候，我告诉你，魔鬼撒旦最怕的就是我们的赞美，魔鬼撒旦最怕的就是我们同心合意的祷告。所以我相信美好的事已经继续在应，只是我们的眼界太有限了啊，所以我们需要求神开启我们心灵的眼睛，让我们看见他正在做事，我们要与他同工，用信心与神同行，用祷告期待神迹啊来到。那么说有两次
请问一下、啊、请问一下哈，你在你这个礼拜你看的这个川普总统说的这些话，有什么事情你觉得跳出来让你觉得啊，这个是就是说不一样的，跟以前他讲的不太一样的，还是然后这个要让我们会特别小心，我们会知道以后要注重什么东西，你有没有觉得他讲的有哪些我们要特殊知道的？
好，我基本上觉得哈，他的态度跟四年前不一样了，神有在改变他，他说话的方式也慢慢的跟四年前不太一样啊，比较不具那么大的攻击性，他只是陈述事实嘛哈，他告诉我们啊，他说很多事要发生啊，那么我们要用信心来相信这些事情。那么他其实讲很多事我们都知道啊，比如说 Rhino 的事啊，拜登上台签了很多行政命令的事啊，那个大选舞弊的事啊，这些我们都已经知道了啊。那么我比较期待能够听到他讲他们计划做什么，因为他不想成立一个新的党。那么换句话说，他等于要在共和党里面清洗这些 Rhino。为什么？因为要强大的民意，所以现在所有的 local 啊的共和党都在谴责那些投票赞成引辟川普的。那么我觉得至少哈、啊，他鼓励我们啊，鼓励我们，所以我们 每一个人如果可能的话，因为基督徒一般都不参与政治的啊，如果可能的话，在 local 你们的 city 或 local county 里面有共和党的或有保守派这些 activity 哈，你可以去 involve， 如果你时间上许可的话啊，因为要 involve 这个事情真的要付代价花时间，因为要去开会，那么你去了人家会认识你啊。那么啊，有一个保守派的在南加州的哈，保守派的大部分都是牧师传道人的一个 conference， 他不定期举行，下次他们举行的时候我可以告诉大家他可以参加。你应该看到很多主流的这个在组内的弟兄姐妹他们如何有实际的可以 involve 这一些人，就在我们的 local 来翻转那些酌情，翻转那些敌对神的事情，我们一定要发声，就是这样子。
嗯，谢谢你。你说的是 Chino Hills 的这个那个牧师的吗？
不是不是不是，不是，这个是外国人的，也不是外国人，我们才是外国人。这个就是他是有一个。我曾经参加过有一个叫 Christian Coalition 的哈，那么另外呢还有一个他们是比较 involve political issue 的一个 conference 啊。有一次我刚好出门不在我师母代表我去参加，那么他说那个非常棒，全部都是非常爱主的基督徒啊。那么我自己本人呢在 Orange County 有一个 group 叫巴拿巴 group， 那么这个巴拿巴 group 呢，它是涵盖哈南加州，从 Orange County 一直到 San Diego County 哈，它每个 quarter 会有一个 gathering， 都在 Irvine 的这个或是 Costa Mesa 的五星级酒店哈。那么在那个地方，我们可以碰到很多爱主的基督徒，他们甚至有的是在主流都有影响力的。那么你可以看见很多这个基督教的 non-profit organization 的负责人，那可以了解他们做什么啊，那么他们借着这个 organization 在做的事情在影响一些这个 event issue 这个很重要的。所以我们最近我收到巴拿巴 group 的开会通知，好像三月他们有2021年的第一季的 meeting 我会去参加的。
嗯，好啊，这个呀，请你把那个 information 给我们看看。Yes，
嗯 ，Mina， 要不要在这段时间，我们等候的时间，是不是可以有个祷告呢？
好，我们现在可以，我们现在来为，
听得
到吗？哎，听得到，听得到呀。Yeah， 这个 Michael， 你讲完了没？你讲完了没啊 ，Michael？
讲完了。
好，谢谢你。OK， 好。
讲完了。
好，谢谢你呀。我觉得我们还有几分钟，我们现在这个来这个为我们刚讲的这个美国的这些事情来祷告。那个请你那个玛丽师母，你能不能开始？那然后那个Tracy， 你可以再下一个，然后其他人再继续下去。
好的，那么祷告的人就自己把自己的麦克风打开好吗？好，谢谢。亲爱的主耶稣，我们感谢赞美你，做每个礼拜我们聚集在一起，做我们接着麦克牧师刚刚所听到的，主啊，真的是你正在川普总统身上，你已经在做美好的工作。主，我们相信你正在做，你也在美国正在做，你在各地正在做，你在列国当中你正在做。主，我们感谢赞美你，你是掌完全的神，你在我们每一个人的生命当中，在每一个城市当中，你正在做翻译工作。你也让我们借着看着这一些许多的黑暗的权势，有很多不公平的事情，有很多的罪恶，主啊，真的是我们更要传扬你的，好让我们能够在这个时刻仰望神，让耶稣基督你的宝血厚厚的责。今天晚上让我们聚集在一起的人，主啊，我们把我们每个人的家庭 把我们的教会，把我们的事工，把我们的城市国家再一次仰望在你手中。主啊，主啊，是的，主，你也在美国的里面。主啊，求神兴起，兴起更多的。哦，主啊，真的是传扬你福音的。主啊，我们也刚刚过这一个普尔节，主啊，反败为胜的这个季节已经到了，已经到了。川普总统昨天他也说没有时间，他知道这些事情是黑暗的事情，不能够继续让下去。主啊，你知道，知道，主啊，我们心里虽然是着急，但是主，我们要你的作为，等候你的作为，求你来掌权，奉主耶稣基督得胜的名祷，阿门。
哎，那主耶稣，我们先来宣告，哈利路亚，众城门啊，众城门啊，抬起头来，那永久的门户要被举起，因为那荣耀的王要进来。是的，主，我们等候你，我们不羞愧，哦，我们忍耐，也终必要得救。主耶稣，我们要被你举起，我们要抬起头来，在这末日的属灵决战里头，求主你亲自来坚固我们，坚固我们每一个信徒，也坚固这个世代。哦，主，我们真是亲身经历到爆发的火焰的试炼临到了我们，但是主你也给我们天国的使命。哦，主耶稣，我们是何等的有福，在这荣耀的时刻，我们可以与你一起同工，哦，与你一起有作为。主，我们感谢你，赞美你。哦，主耶稣，你看到美国正在受逼迫，我们的信仰被逼迫，哦，我们的信心也在逐渐被拆毁。哦，主耶稣，我们为我们这个世代，为我们的下一代，哦，在这真实的灵界征战里头，主，我们要站起来，哦，我们的肩膀要让我们的下一代能够站立起来。哦，主耶稣，我们看到目前所有政治现实的世界，我们要一一来祷告，我们要来寻求你的启示，你的带领。哦，主耶稣，因为我们是盼望那天上的基业，我们是盼望耶稣基督你再来显现的时刻。主，你在经上说，哦，在这末后的世代，那污秽的要继续污秽，那不义的会继续不义。但是主，你已经拣选了我们，我们要成为那圣洁，而且要更加的圣洁。哈利路亚，主，谢谢你，我们实在是有福，我们在这里有经历你的大觉醒，我们不要受大逼迫。哦，主耶稣，愿你复兴你的教会。哦，愿你的信徒比以往更加的火热，因为我们有你做我们的榜样。主，感谢你，赞美你，兴起更多的代祷者，让那祭坛的火熊熊烈火不停息的燃烧。主，我们感谢赞美你，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，奉耶稣的名来祷告， Amen， Amen，
Amen， Amen。
Thank you Jesus， 就是我们谢谢你，让我们这些人在你面前，就是我们到你面前，我们要听你的话语。到你面前，我们想知道你要我们知道的事情。到你面前，你让我们能够彼此互相了解，彼此互相相爱。我们感谢你，在我们在这个时候，求你给我们清醒的这个脑筋，让我们有聪明、有智慧，能够享受从你那里来的话语。让我们不要被世上或者是我们看到的这些新闻蒙蔽，让我们能够看见事实的真相，我们能够追求你要我们知道的真理。我们谢谢你，我们也谢谢你在我们的这个生活当中，你让我们知道除了美国之外，我们还有其他的国家，我们也是在乎的，我们要关心美国，让美国的这个总统以及我们的这么大的一个国家都能够臣服在你的掌权之下。我们还有其他的国家，我们也是很在乎的，我们也为这个埃及祷告，他们正在进步，他们的基督徒正在翻转回来，他们的基督徒正在觉醒，他们的基督徒正在成长，现在他们有20-25% 的这个基督徒。我们谢谢你，求你让我们将来有机会的时候来跟他们谈话，来知道他们做的事情来鼓励他们，来支持他们让我们金钱也能够到达他们的口袋里面，让他们能够做他们该做的事情。我们也为伊拉克祷告，这伊拉克这个国家他们也是 也经过你多少的混乱，有经过多少的这个痛苦，从你创天地来，他们的北部就已经是存在的这个地方，也求你继续带领他们，让他们能够发光，让他们能够也觉醒，也帮助我们也能够为他们出力，帮助我们能够给他们一些资助，也求你带领以色列这个国家，以色列现在也在经过他们经过这个生病的这个患难，我们感谢你给他们全国都已经是有打针了，也求你能够让他们能够觉醒，让他们能够把这个国家打开来，能够接受其他人，也能够去看以色列，我们有一天也要再去以色列，我们有一天也要再去访问他们。求你主耶稣也带领我们在这里的每一个脚步，我们的关心的事情有这么多，但是我们真正更应该关心的事情是主耶稣我们跟你的关系。也求你带领我们，让我们跟你的关系是第一位的，让我们知道你的爱，让我们知道你带领我们实在是真正确确的，我们感谢你，我们这样子祷告，奉耶稣的名，阿们，
阿们。
耶稣，我们感谢
你为着麦克牧师对我们的分享，再次提醒我们要为美国祷告，我们每一位川普总统来祷告，我们也为着共和党的副主席当选是一个弟兄郭弟兄，我们为此来感谢你。我们知道你还是留下7000个人没有向巴黎继续的，所以是无论是对这个 Newsom， 无论是对很多的法案，我们基督徒要站起来，应该要他们的立场，所以是让我们尽我们所知道的能够尽上我们的这一份。我们知道很多的团体，不管是麦克牧师所提的很多的这个Conference， 我们为了所有的这个 Conference， 我们来献上感谢，所以参加的神你的儿女向你献上感谢，让我们极易成求能够发挥这个巨大的力量来这翻转加州。我们就知道加州在20几年前它是属于共和党的，是保守，我们相信你会做工，你会做工。我们知道在大水泛滥的时候你还是作者为王，我们归给你，让我们带着喜乐的心一直勇往向前。谢谢你，你垂听我们的祷告，奉耶稣基督的名，阿们，
阿们。天父上帝，我们满心感谢赞美你，因为我们是你眼中的同仁，你拣选我们，你救赎我们，你也要使用我们。主啊，我们想起大卫，当他面临很多困难环境的时候，他向你祷告说，耶和华，你忘记我要到几时呢？要到永远吗？你颜面不看我要到几时呢？主啊，我们相信你说母亲或许会忘记乳她的孩子，但是你永远不会忘记我们。主啊，我们看见仇敌在美国这一片土地上升高压制我们，要到几时呢？主啊，帮助我们，求你看顾我们，应与我们，免得仇敌欺笑我们，说我们胜了他们。主啊，我们要依靠你，依靠你的慈爱，我们的心要因你的救恩快乐，我们要向耶和华唱歌，因为你定义用厚恩待我们。主啊，我们求你就在这样的艰难环境里兴起你的作为，主啊，好叫我们的心可以欢喜快乐。主啊，我们真是要与你一起同工，求你垂听今天晚上我们众人在你面前的祷告。主啊，你让川普总统回到这个舞台，不但是他一个人，主啊，你要让众儿女国度的精灵都起来，回到社会来发光作盐。主啊，你借着这一次的事件来翻转整个美国，翻转沉睡的教会。主啊，我们要在你面前认罪悔改，因为教会太多的牧者，还有太多的弟兄姐妹，肢体他们沉睡了。主啊，我们需要灯里有油，所以我们恳求圣灵啊，你恩膏我们，你充满我们。主啊，你真是让你的灵，主啊，充满万有的，充满每一个人。然后我们真是在这个时代成为神国度勇敢的精兵，为主打那没胜仗。继续使用以赛亚19，使用总统盾牌的众弟兄姐妹众同工，让我们在我们的生活各个角落来发 发生，并且产生影响力。主要让我们也能够投入社区所有的很多的重要的事情。主要让我们的声音被听见。感谢赞美主啊，荣耀归给你，把得胜主啊归给你自己的名，主啊祝福啊你的众儿女众百姓，祷告奉耶稣基督的圣名。
阿门。
阿门。阿门。感谢，感谢主呀！我看见那个破
长老，
哎，破长老之中啊，好久不见了，龙太。
对，在。呀、yeah, ，在台湾。
Mark 的上来了 ，Mark 上来。
哦，听 Mark， 听 Mark 讲。
上来 ，Yeah。
我，
OK， 你先讲，你先讲。
来，破长老先 say hello 一下。
Hello， 各位弟兄姐妹，大家好。
Yeah，
很想念大家。讲两句。
Hello，Hello，Thank
you。
想念你，想念你。
Yeah， 我现在，对，川普的演讲我也有听，那我觉得第一个很确定呢，他是不会去成立另外一个政党的。刚 Michael 牧师说的，他很确定啊、所以这跟 Mark 港兆的上次分享的一样，因为他说川普在演讲里面有讲，就说那个这样会把票给分走，他说这个是fake news， 可能是对方希望他这样做，但是这样反而是不利的。所以他演讲里面讲清楚，那正如 exactly Mark Gonzalez 所说的。那第二个就是说，我觉得，他现在要做的应该是从地方那个反攻中央啦，因为那个，要他讲的这一些要改造整，他也知道选举哈的这一些的弊病没有毒死掉，那个根本就没有用，所以说。那个，但是这些的权力呢，因为是美国的各州是联合，就说是州政府自治嘛，所以还是呢要在那个州的各级的政府，州政府里面，那来那个制作这些法令，而且要勇敢站起来。其实这一次会失败啊，就是那些的州的，比如说那几个摇摆州的那个共和党，而且是共和党所掌握的，那他们呢？的众议院跟参议院都没有那个勇气站起来，拿着宪法给他们的那个权力去把它给推翻掉。其实权力在他们手上。那我觉得川普可能应该就是说也看到这样，所以他后面几年，这最少这两年的话，就是说要把这个共和党重新改造了，这要大换血，这样子一定要大换血。那我们这些拥护川普的呢？也不是拥护川普，就是说拥护川普运动，他的精神呢，我们要就是说，配合，就是说把能够就是说各级的，就是每个州的参众两院的议员，要把他真的就是要把他们让他们有那个脊椎骨啦，然后呢，而且是要换掉那些那个有那些 rhinos。那所以川普他也一直在 endorse， 他自己也在筛选，所以他说 endorse 的大部分都会上去，所以这个要经过一个大换血，这样子。
OK，
那但是呢，名气可用是因为他做了一件了不起的事情，他四年来觉醒的，光是美国最少8000万觉醒，这个是为什么那个共和党建制派跟民主党都非常怕他的原因啊。那但是这个。他四年就办到这样的事情，那加上全世界也不只是那个，全世界跟着随之觉醒的，那更是庞大的数字。所以，因为这是一个草根性的运动，所以为什么他们害怕川普？那现在就怎么样把这能量聚集，然后那个策略跟战术清楚，然后在各州的里面先攻下来，然后他们能够站在他们位置上面。发挥他们的宪法给的权利，这样子的话才就能够那个地方反包中央这样子。
嗯，哇，谢谢你，你讲的非常的好，这个怪不得人家要听你那个听你的那个节目，你的节目
哪里
叫做什么啊？
啊，末世烽火台，我最近在放空期啊，我现在已经放空，还没放空完，所以还在放。
好啊，我们这个会继续听啊。OK， 好，现在我们现在 那等一下我们要请那个 Mark Gonzalez, are you here, Mark? Mark Gonzalez?
Yes, can you hear me?
Okay, now yes. We can, now we're going to
talk later.
Yes.
Later. All right. Yeah, Mark Gonzalez 就是我们今天的那个讲员，大家来欢迎他。Okay, go ahead.
All right. Well, it's good to be here with you all. Man, I do not know what we've covered or not covered, because so much happens in a day, not even to think about a week. Okay.
我不知道你们讲了哪些，但是是实在有好多事情在这一天发生。
So you may have to ask me some questions here in a little bit to get me, in case I'm leaving some things out. But the biggest thing was was the speech last of Trump, of President Trump that spoke. We don't know what the final numbers are yet, but just on social media alone, 31 million people watched his speech last night.
Wow.
Okay. 他说哈，因为我不知道讲了什么，所以你们可能等一下问我一些问题啊。那这个就是说，昨天他讲的这个演讲呢，就是有3100万的人啊观赏，就是所有这些社交媒体。Okay.
And that doesn't include television. There was 7 networks that carried the speech live, as well as C-SPAN, BBC, BBC UK, Sky News. It was all over the world, from Australia, Canada, you name it, everywhere it came out. So no telling. I believe by the time the numbers come in, it could have easily been 100 million people that watched last night's speech. If we were to count all that, I don't know if they're going to, but if they did, that's what I'm imagining. If we already got 31 million with just social media, with television, it's at least 2 to 3 times that amount.
所以呢，刚刚讲的这个3100万呢，没有包括电视。那电视昨天有7个电视台，包括 C-SPAN、BBC、Sky News， 还有从澳洲到加拿大呢，预计可能有超过1亿的人呢，看到他昨天的演讲。Okay.
Just to put it in perspective, the Oscars, the Globe Oscars that came out last night,
Golden Globe.
Right, only had five, the Golden Globe, there you go, only had 5 million people that watched it. Okay, that lets you know. Mm-hmm. The Golden Globe is the biggest thing that was happening yesterday. And it only got 5 million. Donald Trump, no telling, at least 31 million on social media. No telling how many more just through television.
Okay, 所以昨天晚上刚好是好莱坞的金球奖颁奖，那只有500万人观赏。那川普总统他的在社交媒体就有3100万，那是真的是超过太多倍了。Okay.
So things to be in prayer about. And as you know, you guys can ask me questions on the speech and all of that, but he answered several key questions yesterday. One of them was he going to start a third party? The answer was no. Okay, so he's going to stay within the Republican Party, which makes him the kingpin of the Republican Party. All right. There is nobody. And I know because they did a straw poll. In other words, at CPAC, they do polls within all their audience. Okay. That's what they call straw polls. They did a straw poll and he only got 55%, or at least that's what it seems like, that only 55, right? Well, DeSantis got 23%. Of the vote, as far as for running for president in 2024. My point is this: he was 30% higher than the next closest guy. Let me put it that way. Okay. So yeah, he still rules the Republican Party.
Okay. 所以呢，昨天呢，他有讲的就是说，我们刚讨论过，他不会成立新的这个一个党啊。那他昨天他们也在那边有一些的这个就是调查哈，民调就是川普总统是得到55%。那他们有另外有一个民调之前是23%，所以呢，但是总之呢，就是讲起来呢，他是比那个第二名那个人呢多出30%。OK.
He called out the teacher unions. He called out Biden. He called out the administration. I mean, he literally said the worst first month for any president in the history of America.So, you know, he did, he called it out. He wasn't afraid to do that. And I want to share a few, to let you know, not that we need to know, because this group does believe it got, you know, we know it got stolen, right? That he won the election.
Mm-hmm.
But some of the numbers that he gave last night were pretty mind-blowing.
Mm-hmm.OK, 所以呢他就是他很不惧怕的，他昨天有提到说就是拜登的这是最差劲的这个第一个月的政绩然后呢他也提到说这个选举是被偷窃的，他是赢得这个选举的，然后他提到的一些数字也是相当让人吃惊的。OK。
For instance, He got 63 million votes in 2016. They had said he needed 66 million this go around to win again, and he got 75. Okay. So we're like, he's like, okay, what happened there? I got 63. We needed 66, but I got 75. How did we lose the race?That was one.
是他昨天有讲到说，因为他在2016年是拿到了6300万票，那人家就告诉他说，他要6600万票才能够赢。那他这次拿了7500万票呢，那怎么会可能输呢 ？OK.
He got 94% of the primary vote, and you only need 75% to win the presidential, and he got 94%.So again, how did he lose?
所以呢，在初选的时候呢，他得到94%，然后他只需要75%，他就可以赢得这个选总统的这个资格哈。那怎么可能会输呢 ？Okay,
he got 1.4 million more votes than all the House members combined. Okay, so the thing is.All right, there was 26 toss-up races. We won all 26 races, right? But he still wasn't president. So my point is that there's no way outside of the great steal that took place, the great deception, okay, that took place that he was or could have lost. And then one jab he threw in there, he goes,Of the 122 that I endorsed, 120 won the race.
okay, 所以呢，他说呢，这个就是他呢，有一就是有一okay, 他所有的得票呢，超过所有这些众议员他们所得总加起来所得的票数啊，而且他在26个族裔当中呢，他都是赢的，这是没有办法输的，除非就是一个大欺诈，大诈骗才会输那他也讲到说他也推荐了122个人2个候选人呢、啊、那在所有的选举里面、啊、就是那些共和党的 OK
and then so moving on from his speech last night things that we need to be mindful of that are going on from the election integrity concernThat took place. We won the case finally.
Okay, so you got frozen.
The judge ruled in Arizona, ruled in our favor, So now the election judges and so forth are going to have to bring all the ballots and the machines to the Senate for them to do a forensic audit of the machines and 2.1 million private ballots that they're going to literally get a chance to look at. And that is happening literally as we speak. Those things are being turned over.
所以呢，就是说他昨天特别提到说选举的这个诚信啊，那讲到这亚利桑那州呢，就是现在呢，就是需要有就是要祷告，就让这个法院能够呢，能够愿意啊，能够做这些，而且把这些的票全部都重新的再来啊。算还是什么的、
oh.
OK
no, no. So I gave you the good news first on the election
integrity. OK 我给你们好消息我先给你们好消息
Because as you know since we last talked last week we had the we lost at the Supreme Court OK、The two cases we had at the Supreme CourtWe needed four votes. We only got three. So it got thrown out.
Yeah, 所以呢我们上个礼拜有提到说呢在那个最高法院呢我们有两个案件呢就是说只要四个人同意就可以可是法官只有三个同意所以这两个案件就不通了啊。OK.
Also today,It's a little frustrating to say it, but we lost two more today in Wisconsin and another one in Arizona.
Yeah, so Cindy Powell's two cases, one in Wisconsin, one in Arizona.
And so from that standpoint, you know, these were two losses. We still got 17 more to go. All right. So there's still a lot in play. And we need to pray for favor upon our cases and also courage on those that are listening to do something about this.Because the evidence is there, they're just refusing to even look at it. Okay, they don't want to look at it because if they look at it, they're going to have to judge on this. And it's pretty clear what the evidence is saying here. But nobody has the backbone or courage to take this on. You know, the first sign of courage has come out of Arizona with the state Senate. So we pray for them.But this is why we're praying for courage and backbone and also for favor when those cases get presented, that they'll be more afraid to not hear them than they are to hear them.
OK, 所以我们还有17个案件要进行。所以我们必须祷告的就是说这些法院呢法官他能够真的接受这个案件因为他们现在是说问题是他们连听都不想听那现在就是说要祷告让他们能够听因为所有的证据都在那边那我们要祷告这些法官呢他们能够有骨气并且他们能够呢接受这个案件而且会对这个案件呢有特别的就是说有能够站在这一边站在这个就是我们这一边那 Arizona 这一周呢它已经开始所以我们要祷告这些参议员呢他们能够有公平的处理 OK
OK So I've given you two things I have four OK So we talked about Donald Trump the speech the Trump speech We talked about election integrityNow we're going to talk about legislation that is coming up this week that is very, 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 very important because the future of our country is going to depend on this legislation.
好，所以呢，刚刚我们讲了那个川普的，稍微讲了一下他的演讲，然后也讲到这个选举的这个 公平信可靠度，还有我们要讲的就是这个礼拜要讲到就是立法，因为这个法案呢、啊、对国家是影响非常大。
Even though we don't have dates yet, but the House has already voted on the Equality Act, has already voted on the COVID bill, right? The $1.9 trillion relief bill and H.R. 1. Okay, they've already passed on the House side. Now it's going to come over to the Senate side.
嗯 ，OK， 所以呢，虽然时间还没有定，但是呢，众议院已经就是说通过了平等法哈，而且还有这个新冠病毒的这个补助方案哈，一定有 1.9 兆。那 HR1 这个法案呢，已经在众议院通过，它现在要送到参议院去。
So it's very important.That we keep track of this and what's going on because it's going to affect us, especially as Christians. Okay? The Equality Act is bad news for Christianity, for people of faith, because it comes againstreligious conscience. It comes against, you know, it supports abortion. It supports allowing, making organizations you can no longer say no because it's against your religious conscience. Okay, it deals with public accommodations.Where you have to now make room for transgender and LGBTQ and so forth in your businesses, you know, from restrooms to hiring practices, all of this is now in this equality or more, better said, Inequality Act.
所以我们上次讲的这个平等法案里面包括许多就是在信仰上还有在这个堕胎的法案上面还有这个就是变性啊还有同性啊所有这些很病态的这些法案呢、啊、都在这个 HR1 这个平等法案里面。
So it's very important that we keep track of that, because againThis thing is getting ready to, you know, if when it passes, you no longer have a religious conscience because it's no longer, it literally in there says that you can no longer use religious conscience as a reason why you can't do that any longer.
So, this is why we need to continually注意这个法案，因为就是说，如果这个法案通过了，你不能够用你信仰的这个信念哦来劝人家，或者是来反对人家要变性啊，或是同性的这件事情。
It even goes as far as making sure you use the right pronouns. Okay, because if you don't.They can literally arrest you. It doesn't sound like America, okay? When you start thinking about everything that's inside of this Equality Act.
所以而且你要很小心就是用词啊就是说如果你就是你用的这个词句呢就是如果违反的话这个平等法的话你可能都是犯法的。
So this is going to be very important, you know, for us to be tracking and paying attention to. And I take it back, I think I said HR1.Was now on the Senate side. HR1 is going to be voted on this week by the House.
Oh, this one.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
And then it goes to the Senate.
Oh, 我刚
They already have the votes, by the way, though. But yeah, it's going to be voted on in the House. H.R. 1.
他说我刚刚讲哦，所以 H.R. 1是这个星期才要在众议院来投票的。
Equality Act is H.R. 5.
哦，那平等法案是 H.R. 5. 哦，所以这两个是有不同的。
Okay. H.R. 1 is for the People's Act.Don't let the name fool you, because it's not about the people.
所以这 HR1 他说是为人民，但是你不要被这个他所讲的欺骗了，他不是真的是为老百姓的。
And if God doesn't give some of our leaders a backbone in the next week or two, they literally have the votes to pass this.Well, it's going to pass in the House, which this week it's going to pass. So in it, it has things like illegals can now vote. It has things like you don't no longer have to clean out your voter rolls. So dead people can stay on there. People that haven't voted in 20 years, maybe you moved out. That's why you haven't voted in 10, 15 years.Well, they can't clean out the voter roll, right? So go ahead.
Okay, 所以就是说这个法案呢，就是有关于就是说对于非法的人呢不可以投票这件事呢，他们可能就是很松懈。还有就是说他不能够来好像来更新他们投票的那些人的这些档案哈，就是说有些死人呢已经死了，可是你还是要把他名字留在那里。还有很多人已经二十年都没有投票了，你也不能改他的这个这个情况这样。OK,
you won't need no voter ID. Everything is going to move to mail-in ballots. In other words, it's 2020 on steroids.
所以呢，就是说好像也不需要投票的 ID, 然后呢，所有的选票都是用邮寄的，所以就是2020的就是等于I don't know, is it voting? Anyway, 就是乱七八糟, okay.
The bigger piece that everybody's mainly concerned, well, we're concerned with the whole thing, but it also gives statehood to Washington, D.C., and they also want to add Puerto Rico and Guam. So what that means
is... 所以他们就是说...
Go ahead.
Yeah, 所以他说 so they're going to add the Puerto Rico and the Guam in so
well,
they
that's
have
where they're going to. They're going to start with Washington, D.C. Okay. And so by constitution, they're not supposed to be able to do that. But right now, nobody's following the constitution. That's the point. Okay. That's why it was our Washington, D.C.belongs to the American people, okay? It's not its own state. They want to make it its own state because if they make it its own state, then they get two senators, right? And they got to get congressmen, and they know the two senators are going to be liberal Democratic senators. So that allows them to have 52 instead of 50.
OK, 所以呢，华盛顿 DC 呢，它呢本来是说呢，它不是一个州，一个自己的州，可是他们想要把它弄成一个州，因为这其实是违宪法的。可是现在呢，几乎没有人在遵守宪法哦。那为什么它成为一个州以后呢？因为它就可以有两个参议员哦，然后它就可以呢哦，变成说这个参议院呢就变成有多了两个这个自由派子左派的哈，所以呢就变成52-50，不是像现在50-50。OK。
You add Puerto Rico, you get 54. You add Guam, you get 56.
所以如果你加了波多黎各又多两个就54，然后又加关岛又多两个就变56。
And it'll be a long time before a Republican ever controls the Senate, and they will continue to run their agenda for many, many years to come if they pass H.R. 1.
哦，所以如果他们通过这个 HR 1这个法案呢，那这些刚刚讲的就变56-50，那就永永远远美国呢这个参议院全部都是这些左派民主党所占据，那要很久很久才可能有那个转机。 OK。
And as far as the COVID relief is concerned, we already know it's the no COVID relief bill. Okay, only 9% of the bill deals with COVID. The rest of it has nothing to do with COVID.
That cat. Okay, 所以这个新冠病毒的这个辅助呢，只有9%是真正要帮助老百姓的，其他那些呢，都是要给乱七八糟的各式各样的这个款项，所以你就知道这个政府多腐败。
So with that said, these are things that are happening. We cannot stop praying.There's a lot of important stuff going on in Washington, D.C., from legislation. We see what's going on in the courts, so we can't stop praying about the courts, evidence, exposure, right? But then also, we have some very important nominations coming up this week. One already happened today. We got the Secretary of Education. Go ahead.
No.所以呢，因为呢，就是有这么多的事，所以我们必须不能停止祷告。那现在 DC 有很多事情都在发生，就是像这个下快要有一个教育的部长呢，的提名呢，快要即将要投票通过。
Merrick Garland today, who is being nominated for Attorney General of our nation, came out of the Senate Judiciary Committee.So now it's going to the floor of the Senate for it to be voted upon by all the senators. Okay. We don't want this man to win. I don't know if it can be stopped outside of divine intervention. The point here is, as he's already said, they're going after everybody that dealt with January the 6th. So that's priority number one.So they're about to weaponize that office to go after regular citizens that are not domestic terrorists, but everybody that was there on January the 6th is being called domestic terrorists.
Wow. Okay, 所以呢，他们要提名的有一个就是这个大概是 I don't know what is his office. What is his
Attorney General.
就检察官那他呢、yes. 这个人呢，我们是很不希望他能够当选，因为他说他当选第一件事他就是要凡是1月6号去华盛顿 DC 的所有这些人呢，都要算作你们是美国国内的恐怖分子。
On top of that, he's already said we will probably, now he didn't say it like this, I know we're recording, but we may not be able to play this. But the point is, he didn't say it like this, but pretty much when he was asked the questions, he said, I will decide when I see the material, the Durham material, whether or not anybody else sees that material, which already tells me we're never going to see it.Okay, and Durham was the special prosecutor that was put in charge to investigate the Russia hoax and all of that that was going on behind the scenes to come after Donald Trump. Well, he's already resigned. He already resigned, but he's still prosecutor. But the Attorney General Durham, yeah. But he said, If I win, you're never going to see it. So that's why I think he resigned, because he goes, this is a waste of time to be here because nobody's going to see the light of day.
所以呢，所以这个可怕的人，如果他当选的这个总检察官的话呢，他还要消灭一些证据，就是那个毒汉，他 他就是川普总统，他特别命定他来做一个检察官的哈。那他准备的一些的调查的资料呢，如果那个可怕的家伙当选的时候，他要把这些证据全部消灭，所以这个人他就辞职了，这个杜汉。
And pretty much he will not be getting involved in cases of religious freedom, religious liberty. And he definitely said, I'm not going to get involved with transgender and women's sports. So this is the guy, the number one police chief in the world. Okay. The most powerful guy next to the president.Is the attorney general, because he's got more power to do anything and everything, has already signaled during this nomination process, I'm not dealing with those religious liberty things. Now, he didn't talk about the other stuff specifically. He just talked specifically about the transgender thing. But that just lets you know, I'm not dealing with the life issue, the, you know, because they support abortion, they support LGBTQ,They support all those things that have been what has been taken away our rights as an agenda for people of faith.
所以呢，这个人他呢，因为他要被提名嘛，要投票，那他自己就先说，他说我不会就是来干涉，先干涉宗教自由，也不会参与这个变性啊、同性恋，还有男变性人参加女人运动的这些的事项，他说我不会参与在这些事情啊。那但是他这个人是在总统之外是最有能力的哈，那他就已经先送出这些信号，他说我不会参与这些事，但是真正是怎么样我们也不太清楚。 OK.
And today already four Republicans voted with the Democrats to bring it to a full vote. So if those four stay with the Democrats, they already have the votes because you know Democrats stay together. Okay. It's the Republicans that we can't stay together. So there, if that stays the same way right now, they got 54 votes. So Merrick Garland is going to be the attorney general, in this next vote.
所以他讲的那些什么我不参与宗教自由啊、变性这些，其实就是要骗那些傻的共和党的这些参议员。结果有四个上当被骗，他们就投在民主党的那边。民主党已经有50票，民主党他们都不会跑票，只有是有这些四个笨蛋的共和党的参议员，他就变成54票。
But that is that's kindergarten compared to the next two that we got to be praying about. Is Levine, remember that name, Levine, L-E-V-I-N-E. That is the transgender individual that is running and has to be nominated for the Assistant Secretary of Health for the United States.
OK, 所以呢，刚刚讲的那个呢，对我们等一下要讲的呢，刚刚那个是只是幼稚园，还有一个叫 Levine 这个人呢，他是一个变性人，男的变成女的，那他要成为就是这个健康，就是健康卫生部的那个助理部长。
And I say he.Because that's what he is, okay? and so, I mean, he is crazy.
Yeah.
Believes that we should be teaching kids sex in kindergarten at the age of 3.
Yeah.
Believes that they should be taking puberty blockers by the age of 8.
Oh, yeah.
They should be taking cross-sex hormones by the age of 14. So they can have surgery by the time they're 18.
所以呢，这个Levine他是个神经病，他疯了。他说他要教小孩子性教育三岁就开始，然后呢，八岁就要接受一些的观念哈，14岁要打那些男女混合的这些荷尔蒙，所以他18岁的时候就可以来变性手术，因为他就是一个男变成女的。
And then on top of that, wasn't enough that she also was supporting, remember, she's a secretary, she's going to be assistant secretary of health. So she supported Cuomo and that people with the our seniors with COVID to move them back into nursing homes, but he took his grandparents out of nursing homes. So
他自己就是说，因为那个纽约的那个州长呢，Cuomo，他把很多那些得新冠病毒人都通通送回这个养老院，然后这个Levin呢，他赞成这个州长这么做，可是他把他自己的老人家家里的这个父母呢，却从这个养老院里面啊，老人院里面移出来。
And believes that he can that children can make their own decision of what gender they are by the age of 5. Okay.
他说他认为孩子5岁就可以自己决定要当男或是当女。
So I'm not going to. I was going to play you a little clip. I'll get back to it if we get a chance to.
Can we ask a very important question?
Yes.
Yeah, because last night Trump said that he said the Democrat already lost the White House. 昨天晚上川普总统有讲，他说民主党已经丢了白宫，输了白宫。 He said they already lost the White House, and this is a lost thing. Because I read that several times. I listened to his speech. Several times. He did say that.
Yeah, well, we're not reading too much into all of that because everything that, again, you know, when we start going down these paths of the military's in this person's hands and that person's hands, and, you know, we don't know, and people have failed us at every turn. Okay, so I'm not going to go down that journey there.
Direction.
What he did say is this: we're taking back the House and the Senate in 2022, and the Republican is going to take back the White House in 2024. And who knows who
he didn't mention 2024. He didn't mention this 2024. No.
Yeah, he did. Mm-hmm. I heard it. Yeah, he did. He said that. No, not that he was running 2024, that a Republican would take the White House in 2024 and pretty much teased us, okay, who could it be, right? Just quote unquote. We already know he was talking about himself, but he didn't say that. All right, so those are things that we know for sure. Some of the other things, I'm not going to try to decipher through them because, again, we go back to the point of because people are lacking the courage right now to do what they're supposed to be doing, even if there's been a play that we could have made, right? I mean, look at the Supreme Court of the United States of America. Has already turned down 4 cases at the U.S. Supreme Court, right? And then even before the election, the Supreme Court failed us. They told Pennsylvania, you do what you want to do, right? So this is where all this mess got started because Roberts and the Supreme Court did not want to deal with the election. Dealt with it right there. We would have been in a different place right now as we speak.
Okay. So 我问他说，昨天因为我听川普总统讲到说，民主党已经输了白宫。那这个马克是说呢，他是讲说要在2022年先在众议院赢回来，然后呢，在2024年呢，才会有新的共和党的总统，那会是谁？那我说我没有听到他讲2024，那他说他有哈，所以他是说因为呢。 因为呢，在美国有太多这些像那个最高法院，他们都没有骨气，都不愿意来接这些案件的时候，就是在选举的时候，威斯康宾州的他们也不愿意接，到现在有四个案件，也他们都不愿意来碰触这个选举的事情，所以呢，才会沦落到今天这个景况。Okay.
And I'm just going to mention one more individual. You all know him from California very well. Javier Becerra, okay, who was, the, was from California, is now Attorney General of California. Now he's going to be the Director of Health and Human Services in the U.S. here in D.C. That is the most, put it this way, all the money runs through the HHS. They got the biggest budgets. They got the most organizations that they oversee, agencies, not organizations, agencies, that they oversee. And it's being run, it would be run by Javier Becerra, who is one of the most anti-religious liberty individuals on the planet. He's the one that came against Sisters of the Poor. He sued pro-life groups, pregnancy centers. He's put people in jail. All of these things. They're in California, by the way. For anybody that's trying to take a stand and come against the government, he has come at them with everything, the whole book of the law. Well, now, if he gets nominated, he's in charge now there in Washington, D.C., of Health and Human Services, and they're going to be able to run this whole agenda. So it's just not going to be what we talked about, you know, H.R. 5, the Equality Act, but now you have Becerra, Levine, Garland, and then this Espinosa guy that got put in today, that all support LGBTQ, all support transgender, all support all these things. Plus, you get the Equality Act. Get ready, because persecution is coming to the church in America as soon as next week, like never before.
Okay. 所以他讲说呢，这个加州有一个哈，这个老莫名字的哈，那他呢就是要被提名当这个人类健康部门的啊，那个是一个就是呢这个部门呢，那这个人呢他是一个最逼迫这个宗教，他是最反宗教的，就是说他就是说上次呢他还把一些就是 pro life 的，就是那些爱护生命的，还有那些的。他都把人家送入监牢，所以你要等着看吧。下星期开始呢，这个宗教的这个逼迫就要开始了。
Do you have any good news for us? I mean, you have been telling all this bad news.
All the bad news.
No. My point is, I said that because these next week, 2 weeks, we have a whole different America. I mean, it's moving that fast. You pass H.R. 1.
It's bad.
You pass H.R. 5, and you get Merrick Garland, Javier Becerra, and Levine, all with power now to call shots, to run regulations, to run different programs. I mean, we did a complete 360 as a nation in a matter of weeks. This is why, because this is what I'm telling people, we better wake up, because you won't be in the same America. We're going to look like China. We'll be under persecution.
他说，因为他我们说你怎么都给我们坏消息啊，他说他主要是要告诉我们说，从下礼拜开始，只要 HR1 HR5 呢通过这两个法案之后呢，你就知道美国就不像现在的美国，它就会像那个红色铁幕的中国共产党一样，就是这些的逼迫就会临到美国，我们的日子就不好过了。他就在警告我们。
And so you may have heard, I'm going to give you one more piece of bad news.
Oh my goodness!
Okay. No, Jerry Nadler. This is where we're at right now. And I got all these videos. I mean, just because I got to track all these things that are going on. Jerry Nadler on, what are we right now? Monday, I think it was Friday. He literally said on the floor of Congress, okay, the House of Representatives, one of the representatives stood up and began to talk against the Equality Act, okay? And literally, Jerry Nadler stood up and said right there on the floor when he was talking, okay? When he was talking there, he literally told the people there that were making the comments, because he talked, the representative was, the congressman was saying is, if we start allowing transgender, we start doing hormones and puberty blockers, we're changing the will of God for humanity. This is what he was saying. Okay, so he wasn't saying things that are far out there. And then Jerry Nadler gets up and literally says, you know, right in front on the microphone, it's recorded for history's sake, God's will is no concern of this Congress.
Wow, OK. 所以呢，当他们在讲到哈，就是在这个参议院的时候，他们在开会的时候呢，有一个人他起来反对这平等法案，他说呢，如果要通过这个法案呢，那会改变了神的话哈，神的话了。那这个 Jerry Nadler 这个家伙呢，他就说，他就当着麦克风对着大家哈，就记录起来说，他说神的话在我们这个参议院是没有地步的，没有位置的，没有地位的。
So my point is, when you say these kind of comments from the United States on U.S., our capital, that is the government structure of our nation, there's going to be repercussions coming, not just to Jerry Nadler, not just to the Democrats, but to our nation, and they may even touch the church. This is why we pray, because what they're doing right now, there is no fear of the Lord, there is no fear of the church, and they're just completely unhinged. And when the swift hand of God begins to manifest, some of us in the church are going to have to deal with some of these consequences as well, because this is being said here from our government structures.
所以他讲的那一句呢，这么不敬畏神的话呢，居然是从美国的首都参议院国会里面说出来的。这是一个红色的警戒啊，就是说，所以我们必须要祷告哈，因为他们这么不敬畏神，也不怕神，不怕教会，而且呢，这些啊，就是说有一些教会呢，他会呢，同时会受到一些的恶果哈，因为可能他们支持这个民主党。OK.
But there are good news. Here's the good news. People are waking up, and that's what needed to happen. We were asleep. Now all of a sudden, you got parents that are going on strike or protesting the unions. Look at what just happened in California, right? This individual, Berkeley Unified School District, the union said they closed down all the schools. And they said, we're not going to have schools till all the teachers are vaccinated. So they shut down all the schools. They haven't gone back to school. But then yesterday, they caught the president of the union taking his kid to a private school so we could have in-person learning. They busted him, okay? They caught him on video, and it has gone viral as of today. So it's not by accident that today in California, they said they have cut a deal and schools are gonna open by the end of the month. It wasn't by accident.
OK， 所以呢，就是说呢，这是像这个在这个加州 Berkeley 呢，他们说要把所有学校都关掉，老师要打这个疫苗。那可是呢，这个学校的就是那个学区的人他自己呢，把小孩送到私立学校去学习，那好像被人家逮到，所以他们就说这个学校要重新开放，就是大概在下个月吧。他刚刚讲我，
Orange County。The athletes in Orange County just sued Gavin Newsom. They said, we are done. We want to go back to school. We want to play sports. And you're not going to stop us. Okay? I mean, the grassroots is rising up. They did the same thing in Chicago. They've done the same thing in New York. They're doing it all across America. The grassroots is starting to rise up. And said, look, man, we've had it. The government has their foot on our necks, on our throats, and we're done with this, and we're taking a stand. Yes. You have states right now that just came out. Let me see if I can pop up the headline that are literally saying, we're not going to obey the executive orders.
Okay, so let me translate. 他说好消息就是说现在呢大部分都慢慢在觉醒起来了哈，所以呢在这个呈现 Orange County 他们也要告这个我们加州的那个州长嘛，他说我们这学校我们要把小孩送回学校，要他们要玩球，他们要到学校去上课。那不仅是加州，芝加哥、纽约所有这些的州呢，大部分家长都在抗议了，然后有许多的州呢，他们都要拒绝这个总统的总统令，他要找出了哪些州。OK。
So this is just one state, just so you can see it.
Texas.
But this is what they're doing. People are saying, we're going to reject the executive orders. We're not going to listen to your executive orders, Mr. President.So you can keep signing them. You can keep doing 63 executive orders as we speak right now. Okay. So they're saying.
Yeah. 奥克拉荷马州说我们不甩你，你就签你的总统命令吧。我们这个州不执行你的总统命令。
South Dakota. I mean, all kinds of states are saying, nope, we're not. So they're literally passing laws in the state legislatures.To say we're not going to obey the executive order. So in other words, this whole thing is being exposed. You got the Democrats that are telling Biden, reverse your executive order. You have unions that are telling Biden, reverse your executive order. You're seeing all of this stuff happening. You got mayors, Democratic mayors, that are telling them, hey, man, what you're doing on the border, you need to stop because you're killing our cities.All these things, they're turning on each other right now, and it's waking up the American people.
OK, 所以呢，现在就是说呢，因为呢，拜登签了这么多总统命令呢，那所有这些的民主党本身的这些的市长啦，还有这些的union, 还有这些工会哈，还有他们都跟着拜登说你要。把你的这个撤回啊，你这些总统命令，因为你的总统命令呢，在杀害我们的城市啊，所以现在民主党本身起来在起内讧了，他们现在都在反对他的总统命令。
Alabama just announced the first university that just announced we're doing 100% full stadiums, 100% full classrooms in the fall.No ands, ifs, or buts about it. We're opening full-blown in the fall. Stadium, sports, you name it. So everybody's saying, because remember what's going on right now. We're seeing the COVID numbers go down. So how do they keep you locked in? Oh, there's a new wave coming. The fourth wave is coming now. There's a new variant coming now, right? So they want to keep you with 2, 3, 4, 5 masks, okay? They want to suffocate you while you walk, anyways. But the point here is, you know, all of this. So they got to keep making up stories. And the American people are saying, we're done, man. We're not listening. You can keep talking all you want to. Fauci, CDC, we're not listening.
所以呢，他们就是说，所有许多的 大家都起来反抗说呢，到秋天呢，我们要100%我们的体育馆，我们的所有的那些的棒球场，通通都要开，因为这个 COVID 这个新冠病毒的人数下降，那你为什么还要把我们关起来呢？那他们又自己在造故事编故事说，哦，还有新的一波新的病毒会来，那我们那大部分的民众都起来说，你别吹牛了，我们不甩你了。 OK,
so there are good, there's silver linings in all of this. This is why, and I go back to that point. Remember when God saysI need to do something bigger than just the Trump train. Mark, can I trust you? Right? Because all of this stuff needs to happen. All this exposure needed to take place. And we're not done yet. This is only the beginning. And so this is what God is saying. I got to clean up so much mess. All right? I need more time. And right now, with all the prayers of God's people in a concentrated amount of time, it's allowing for the lid of corruption to come off and everything get exposed. So that's where we're going. And we believe that March and April are going to be key in this corruption and this exposure, the corruption being exposed like never before.
所以呢，这些呢，就是说我之前有告诉你们说，这个 Trump 的火车呢，这个是不够的，就是要扩大。所以为什么要拖这么久？因为他必须要把这些的败坏、这些的腐败呢，把它一直累积到，就是到后来这个盖子会被掀开、会爆炸哈。所以三月、四月是一个很重要的关键点啊，就是这些全部被曝露之后呢，所以那些的这些腐败都必须要都必须要这些都要发生的啊，所以这些事都要发生。但是三月四月会有一个关键点。
So more evidence is coming. You may have heard Mike Lindell on Sunday. He also said that there's some more evidence coming out in the coming days and weeks.We know we got 17 cases still to go before the courts and state legislators. So we got people working on that, that are still working on that from evidence perspective and forensics and audits and all of that. We see what's going on in Arizona. They're going through audits. All that information is being turned over. So there's a lot to be in prayer about. And by the time this is over...It's going to be ugly by the time it gets clean, and it's going to get worse by the time it gets better, okay? And so this is how it works, because all of this is being exposed. I don't like it, okay? But I want to, for the glory, like Jesus said in the Bible, for the glory that was set before him, he endured the cross, okay? So because we know it's going to be better on the other side, I don't pay too much attention to all the stuff going on. I just pray into it. Pray, fast, pray, fast, whatever. However the Lord leads you. But we win at the end of the day.
OK, 所以呢他讲到说这个麦林道他也讲到说还有更多的证据会继续的曝露出来，因为我们还有17个案子正在法院里面进行哦，那些人呢，那些参与的人都还在很认真的在做哈，关于犯罪的这些的证据呀，还有这些种种的哈，那阿里桑那还有很多的，所以我们需要一直祷告。那因为要变好之前一定会变得非常的丑陋，但是呢因为我们知道呢它会变好，我们也不喜欢这个光景这么丑陋，但是因为我们想到说它会变得最后会变得很美好，所以我们就是不要去注意其他的事，我们就是用祷告呢把这些事一直把它祷告，你要进食，你要祷告神感动你，你就把它祷告，把它推进去这个美好的结局。Okay.
Well. So are you then talking about it, Mark? Or do you have more?
No, I think y'all had enough. I don't want your head to explode. But, you know, we started with the good news. That was Donald Trump. and the ratings and the amount of people. Then we talked about the middle was ugly. All right. But then we talked about, we closed out with what's going on with the culture, the grassroots, right? So we started with the good news, had a bunch of not so good news, and then we ended with good news again. So with that said, we're as a country, we're going through a tough time. When I say tough, is a time where we're being stretched, and mm-hmm. God is making believers out of us, not just Christians. There's a difference, okay? Mm-hmm. There, you can be a Christian, you can be saved, but it don't mean you're a believer, right? Mm-hmm. God is looking for believers right now.
Mm-hmm.
And is going to make you a believer.
Okay, so, 刚讲说好，你快讲完了吗？他说好，我们是从好消息开始的，因为川普总统出来演说嘛，然后中间讲了一大堆很丑陋的事。可是呢，我最终呢，我就是讲到说，就是我们将来会有好的，因为这些草根的老百姓的崛起，所以这也是好消息。所以我们也是从好消息要好消息结束。那么最后呢，就是说我们也知道说这个我们这些事情呢，就是最主要就是要让这些基督徒，你只是一个基督徒，而是要真正成为一个主的门徒啊，就是你要跟随主的啊，所以这件事情也是神在过滤，在筛掉一些的，要把让基督徒能够更加的更忠心于主，更深入 ，OK。
You see, because I mean, imagine, just to give an example of how things are accelerating. Look at Cuomo, the governor of New York. He was the media darling. He was the COVID darling. All right. And in a matter of days, okay, if he makes it to the end of the week, it'll be surprising to me. All right, because today Pelosi and Hillary both wrote statements against him and in favor of the ladies. And then after that, a third lady came out. Okay, but now mind you, all this corruption that is now being exposed is corruption that's been there for decades. You see what I'm saying? We're leaving in that moment in Joel where God is saying, I'm going to give you the former rain and the latter rain in the same month. Okay, it's being condensed and it's shooting out the stuff and the mess is coming out. So they better get on the right side of prayer because the hand of God's about to touch and reach and touch a whole bunch of folks. And they're not going to want to feel that hammer.
OK， 所以呢，我们讲他分享这些，就是要讲说事情发生的是非常的以快速度在发生，因为你知道那个纽约的州长那个库莫呢，他之前我们称他是这个COVID 冠状病毒的达人哈，因为大家都好像他做得很好，可是呢现在呢，因为他呢性骚扰三个女士，所以今天呢这个 Nancy。那个老妖婆她跟那个希拉蕊呢，他们两个都出来写声明说他们支持那三位那些被骚扰的女性，所以他们等于说是拿棍子在打这个郭某哈，所以现在呢这个事情要被曝光，而且是很快的，因为神应许说春雨秋雨呢，可是等于集中在一个月，春雨秋雨通通都下下来，所以他们这些人呢，这些犯罪的人呢，他们都要现在都要发抖了，因为神的锤子就要来锤他们了。OK，
yeah， so imagine those teachers in San Francisco. I'm trying to give you some pep right here. Remember San Francisco, they were trying to change all the names of all the schools. They even went after Feinstein, Abraham Lincoln, George Washington.They went after everybody, take all their names because they got slave owners and blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. They were trying to be politically correct.
Yeah.
Right. And then they start talking and then they think they're off the air and they're talking and it gets played in the air and everybody hears them talking about, if you come after me, I'm going to hit your back. They started talking about, you know, they think we're their babysitters. They just want their babysitters back. All this is playing in the air publicly. Okay. And somebody sends them a, you know, you're live on the air, right? What? Whatever. Within the next day, the chairman resigns. The day after that, the whole board of trustees resigns. And then San Francisco makes an announcement. You know, all that whole time is coming that same time. They make an announcement. We're no longer going to be dealing with the schools, with the naming of the schools. We're going to focus on reopening the classroom. You see, this is God. I mean, people, they think they're in control. God's in control through our prayers. And God can move it. That happened within days. From all these crazy people in charge, the God cleaned house and took them.
所以南 San Francisco 他上次讲到说那些那些教那个学校那些的局，他们说要把那个学校的名字哈，所有那些命名为这个美国的那些伟大的有名的人物的名字的学校都要把它改名，那都不让学校重新开张，那所有这些的家长呢都起来反对哈，所以他们都起来反抗，所以后来现在就是说等于说在一天之内呢他们全部抗议呢，所以他们很多教育局的都辞职了，所以神正在做很快速的工作，要把这些渣滓通通把他们清除掉啊，所以让甚至教会里面那些的这些的渣滓呢，通通都要把它清除。Okay.
So this is going to happen swiftly. When it starts, when the hammer starts to drop, when that arm of justice starts to strike the ground, and it's already started, when God says, "Okay, I'm going to deal with that one today," bam, you're going to start seeing stuff just shift. Okay, so this is why I'm telling people, don't get so caught up with this little, you know, no. God's going to clean house because there's so much that needs to happen. So right now we focus on the corruption. We focus on God exposing evil. And while all that is going on, heads are going to start to roll and automatically some are going to go to jail. Some are going to get taken out. Some are going to have to resign. Some are going to get impeached. Some are going to, you know, they're trying to do all of that to Cuomo. See what I'm saying? It lets you know there's impeachment. There's resignation. There's all these things. So when all that happens, okay, then we got to fill in the blanks. Okay. I don't know what the blanks are going to be yet. We just pray.
OK， 所以呢我们讲说呢，好像说是那些恶人掌权，其实是神在掌权所以现在呢神就是说这个铁锤已经准备好了哈，是说神他决定要来对付哪一个部门呢，他就铁锤敲下去呢，那这些事情丑陋的事，所以这些人都会被清理有些要坐牢，有些要被抓起来，有些要辞职有些要被弹劾，所有这些事情通通都被清理干净了之后呢，然后再来填空，把这些空缺呢填回去。那所以呢所有这些事说我们必须要来祷告，因为事情会发生的很神速的，非常快速的。
Amen.
OK.
Wow.
Man. So pretty much I've covered all the territory I needed to cover, but it's all coming out.
Okay.
And you know, so and what President was able to do during his speech that nobody else could do, he was able to call out the Biden administration. He was able to, you know, that the line that got that's getting the most friction right now is when he said we need to protect women's sports from the transgender. That thing is, they're coming after him more than for that line than anything else in the whole speech.
所以呢，在昨天呢，就是他所这个川普总统所演讲的有一句呢，有最重要的、最受到这个这关注的，就是他讲到要我们必须要保护 妇女的运动，因为这些变性人他们要参与在妇女的运动项目里面，这件他说的这个事项呢，所以最引起到很多的关注。
So it wasn't by accident that today Miss USA okay, the pageant, right? You don't have to have transgender women participate in Miss USA. Because last year they had to. This year they didn't.
OK, 所以呢，今天呢，所以那个美国小姐的选美大会的这些评审呢，他们讲说呢，我们今年不能有这个变性的女子来参加这个选美，因为他们去年是允许的。
So it's you just learn to smell the roses along the way. You get a victory here, you praise God. You get just give God glory, and He's gonna give us the big old robe, the whole garden by the time it's over. Okay, so we just keep praising and thanking God along the way, and we don't stop praying, amen. Because there's so much that needs to be done.And the more we pray, the more God can do.
Amen.
所以我们要不停，我们要不停的祷告，然后沿路呢，一面闻这个玫瑰的香味呢，然后把荣耀归给神。每一个地方，每一个点呢，得到胜利之后呢，我们就把荣耀归给神，然后神就会把整个玫瑰花园都赏给我们。所以我们要不停止的祷告。
Amen. So what?Thank you. So we're going to have about a couple more months of this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
At least.
Well, I was believing Q dropped. They said that Trump is coming back in March or April.
Well, like I said, there's going to be, as things get cleaned out, there's going to be boxes that are going to have to get full and filled up again.I don't know. Is the White House box needs to get filled again or what? Okay.
Yeah.
That it's about the cleaning as the cleaning and the corruption take place. And they're talking about divorce. He goes, if I never would have got a divorce, I never would have met Joe Biden. Because Kelly Clarkson also just had a divorce. So she was telling Kelly Clarkson, your days are going to get better. It's going to be okay.Because I got a divorce and blah. I'm like, you're the first lady of the United States of America. What are you doing talking about divorce in public?
OK, 他是讲到说，因为我问他说，我是相信 Q 讲到说川普会回来。那他说，因为呢要先清理所有一些的空位出来。那这个白宫呢可能会空出来，因为按照现在看这个拜登呢，他的身体的情况呢，真的是越来越糟糕。他去哪里呢？他都没有办法完成一个句子哦。然后呢，就是说那个这个副总统已经都在不要说副总统，就那 Harris 已经都在帮助他打电话。然后这些民主党的也都要他就是那个核子这个核按钮呢，不能够让他一个人来决定，因为他已经老人痴呆。我们不是要取笑他老人痴呆，可是因为他的身体情况。让全世界都在取笑美国，说这个老人痴呆症的人在掌管美国的大全国家大事。然后呢，他的太太就呢，这真的不是一个好的第一夫人，因为他去接受电视访问的时候呢，他就因为这个电视主持人 Kelly 他正要离婚啊，就跟他说，哦，离婚很好啊，你看我就是因为离婚我才认识了我的这个老公Joe Biden。 所以你看他是第一夫人，他居然在电视里面鼓吹离婚很好。 OK
So this is why there's going to be some things that are already happening, and if it wasn't that he'sleading our country, I mean, the hell in a handbasket. You know, I feel sorry for him anyways. But my point is, he's bringing a lot of this on himself. He had no business running for president. But the reason he's, you know, and part of this whole deal is, you know, that's going on and taking place.
He's a perfect.
Is, you know, this Biden enterprise of corruption and taking money from China, padding their own bank accounts, all of that. You know, it was going to take the presidency to keep his whole family out of jail. Okay. But the point here is this thing, you know, they're going to do the 25th Amendment on this, on him here sooner than later. And so we just, we'll see when that is. Then it becomes Kamala, even though she's worse. But then, you know, we just see what happens is all this stuff gets exposed. We don't know what's going to take place, but we'll see. Okay. I'm not ruling anything in. I'm not ruling anything out, but I'm not ruling anything in. Okay. We're going to let it play out.
All right. All
right. Yeah.
All right. Okay. Well, wonderful, Mark. It's been a while, over 1 hour, that we really appreciate your speaking. And because the time, and you know, I kind of have to. I think everybody knows. So we heard so much today, up and down and up and down. But in the end, we trust our God will win, and this is why yes. we're here.
Yes.
你要讲吗
？Yes.
就是说呢，因为他刚刚讲到说，就是虽然说这个 Harris 会更糟糕，但是我们知道这个取向就是这样，这我们要相信神哦，我们就是持续祷告哦，我们知道哦，神还是在掌管一切的哈、哦，所以我们也就是持续祷告，不停止祷告就对了。OK，
we appreciate you coming here. Is any I guess I'm open. We're open to a couple of questions. Anybody has a question?
有没有问题？我们只开放一两个问题。
Does anyone have a question? Michael, you
像 Jaren 他刚刚有问 Jaren.
Yeah, could I ask a question, Mark? When you say that Biden isn't doing too well, and this is very concerning if Kamala, that she's doing all of the running all of the business of the White House, this is worrisome because she's so evil and aggressive. Just how do we face her?
And
if there's no turnaround, then what do we do with
that? Well, here's the thing. The agenda is more aggressive than her. This is what we got to be mindful of. This is why I was sharing about these people, because the agenda is more aggressive even than Kamala. This is the right now, Biden and Kamala are literally being played like puppets. And I don't say it in a demeaning way. I'm saying it basically in a literal way. Okay, for instance, this bombing that we just did in Syria, Kamala was mad because she didn't even know about it. We bombed the whole country and didn't even tell the vice president. I'll let you say that.
Yeah. Not even Biden. Yeah, 所以他说有这问题，就是说，这个卡梅拉，呀，我们觉得他很邪恶，怎么办？怎么来面对？那 Mark 说啊，这些议案就是现在的这个伪总统、伪副总统，他两个呢都是傀儡啊、真正的啦啊、是那些邪恶的那些的法案才是我们比较需要去担忧的。所以那他刚刚有讲我没有翻译，就是说他为什么这个拜登他实在不适合选举，但是他选举的目的就是因为他们家从中国贪了很多的钱，那他选总统就是为了说不要让他们全家族去坐牢，所以他就出来选，原因之一。好，
So yes, we do have to pray. There is a prophetic word that was given out there by Charlie Shamp on Kamala.That she has this epiphany and begins to realize that she's being used and she's being played and that she has a turning around. Like I said, I saw it. I read it. I've read it myself. So I read it. I know what it says. We still want a Donald Trump, okay? We don't want a Kamala. But the point here becomes is that there is that word that was declared, okay? Because I'm thinking we, you know, it can't be that she's at every meeting with Joe Biden.
Yeah.
And it's doesn't thinking even get to say a word.
Yeah.
After a little while, that starts working on you right here. Okay. And, you know, and every time I see that, I just remember of that prophetic word that was said that she was like, I'm being used, man. I'm done with this. So we'll see if that happens. Yeah. That's why we just pray. There's so much out there that's, you know, at work right now. God is working on so many levels. Amen. We just got to pray and trust him. And don't try to read too much into the lines.
Yeah. Okay.
Because when God starts doing it, you're going to see it loud and clear.
Amen.
So if these two are the puppets, then who is the real, the true dictators behind?
All the Obama people that have been put back into this White House.
Yeah. Oh, I see. Yeah.
所以他讲话可说呢，因为他有看听过一个先知预言，这个 Harris 就是那个伪副总统，说他会有一个觉醒，说发现他自己是被人利用了，然后呢，他就会发现说，情势不妙，然后他就会想不干了，所以这件事情到底会不会发生呢？因为他读了这个预言以后，他觉得也很有可能，因为他每一次看到这个伪副总统，他站在这个伪总统的后面呢，可是每一个场合呢，他都没有让他讲过一句话，所以他就觉得说，可能久了以后，他就觉得这个是不太对劲的，可能他就有个大觉醒。
Yes. Okay. Well, so
总理说普京说那个川普赢了是代表什么意思？
真的吗？
还是真的有这个事情吗？普京说川普赢了。
Yeah.Yeah, Putin said in one YouTube program, he said that Putin in an economic, you know, he said that all the deep state, all the global government, they haven't even started and already failed. So Trump won the election. That is in one program. They asked, what does that mean? He said Putin, the Russia president, said that. He said Trump won.The election because
they were messing with the election.
okay, yeah, okay. 因为呢，因为俄国他们也参与在这个总统大选的舞弊里面，他们也是其中之一国，所以他们现在要讲这样来修补一下。
All right. Well, there. I guess. Way too many.
Yeah. Can I?
Way too many things.Yes.
Yeah. Just one quick question. Quick question. When you said the Supreme Court, we lost two cases in Supreme Court last week. You mean the Supreme Court decided not to take the case?
Yes. That's what you mean. Yes. Yeah. Those were losses for us.
They don't matter.
Because we needed them to take it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's different from like the.They took the case and then a verdict was like we lost.
No, they reject. 他们最高法院拒绝. And one more question.
We needed four votes and we only got three. Thomas, Alito, and Gorsuch voted in favor to take on the case.
Yeah, we talked about that last week.
Barrett,And Kavanaugh, we needed one more, and because we only got three, they couldn't take on the case to go to the next phase. So that was the deal there.
And one question, one person asked is the U.S. Army, all the military. Is that military can do something about all this evil? There's one person asked in the chat.
The military
is a military involved.
Military has to obey their allegiance is to the Constitution. Okay.
Yeah.
having said that, they got liberties to do certain things.
Yeah.
That go beyond the government. Okay.
Yes.
The point uh-huh. comes in is okay. Do we have generals out there that are on our side or on the side?
Yeah.
Of
yeah. Do they have
the courage and the boldness to then exercise that authority? And so far, we don't. We haven't had it yet, but we pray.
But I thought the bombing the Syria is a military's decision. It's not Biden's decision, though.
Well, it came from the White House, even though it may not have been. Like I said, it's the people around Biden. Okay, but it was authorized by the Biden administration. Okay,
that is because, added.
Huh?
So the people that after the aftermath, they add this comment, said that a White House comment that by they said that it's Donald Trump, it's the military. They order this bombing.
Yeah, well, I mean, you got a lot of, I'm not going to say they're conspiracies, uh-huh. but the point here is right now, Donald uh-huh. Trump does not command the military. He has people that have loyalty to Donald Trump, yes, but he uh-huh. doesn't command the military, okay? Not officially. Uh-huh. Now, if something needs to happen because it gets so, so crazy, look at Myanmar. Look at other places. Now, I don't anticipate that happening in America, okay? There's still too many other steps that are still out there that can be used. But, yeah, I'm not going to go down that path because they said that about the Insurrection Act before. They said that about martial law before. None of that happened, okay? So QAnon, all them people have been talking. And everybody's been wrong because it hasn't happened. Now, could it? That's a different thing than did it happen, okay? And because the military has to obey the Constitution, we'll see what happens right now. But officially, technically, Biden is the commander-in-chief as long as he's at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
All right. Okay. Yeah. Well, I guess that is our this evening's teaching, and thank you so much. 因为时间的关系，我们今天就到了这里。然后呢，我们来祷告，然后我们让大家走。Okay, yeah, okay. Let's pray. 那个 Michael， 你会替我们祷告吗？
做结束祷告。
天父上帝，我们恭恭敬敬来到你施恩的宝座前。今天我们从我们的弟兄 Mark 听到他很多的分享，有关美国目前社会、政府立法机构、国会一些现况。主要虽然我们听到很多的坏的消息，好像逼迫一步一步临近，好像恶人猖獗。掌权作王，主啊，但是我们相信大水患难的时候你仍然高高坐着为王。主啊，叫我们不丧胆，也叫我们不丧志。主啊，让我们真的知道我们得赎的日子是何等的迫切。主啊，你当欢喜快乐迎接那荣耀的王将要再来。主耶稣，我们也呼求你在这个时代有你口中的气，主啊，来吹灭那一些抵挡你的恶者，主啊，让我们计谋破败。主啊，你也在艰困的时刻保守你指明你的众百姓们，主啊，让他们十分的平安，让他们在你的翅膀荫庇底下被你隐藏在高处。主耶稣，这些风浪必不临到我们。主啊，我们要安稳在你的手中。主耶稣，你施恩给我们，不管是坏消息，不管是好消息，那我们都知道我们在世有苦难，但是我们在基督里有平安。所以帮随时随地随处，让我们都进到你的里面，享受那世界所不能给予也不能夺走的平安。 主，我们谢谢你，我们赞美你，谢谢主，不但领受这些知识，让我们更是从你的话语里面得着力量与安慰。祝我们今天晚上每一个人都有一个美好的休息，让我们躺下一觉到天明。正如诗篇127篇第二节下半节所说的，唯有耶和华所亲爱的必叫他安然入睡。奉主名宣告，我们今天在座的每一位都是耶和华所亲爱的，世界的纷纷扰扰不能动摇我们里面那已经得着的宝贝。我们把荣耀颂赞感谢全民能力为你归给你，把在基督里一切的平安喜乐祝福健康归给在座的每一位。听我们的祷告祝福宣告，奉耶稣基督得胜的名，阿们
阿们
阿们阿们。